Halo semuanya, balik lagi bareng Simpan Segaming di sini. Di video ini aku bakal membahas beda banget. Ini bakal ngebahas tentang Master Europe yang kemarin hari Sabtu dan Minggu week 2-nya mulai dan ada day 2 dan day 2. Day 1 dan day 2 gitu. Nah, di sini aku bakal ngebahas tentang momen-momen terbaik di week to day two, soalnya aku nontonnya adalah yang hari keduanya ya, di hari minggunya gitu. Jadi aku nggak ngebuat untuk video day satunya ya. Mungkin next week ya, week 3 aku bakal coba ngebikin momen terbaiknya di day 1 dan day 2 gitu. Jadi dua video terpisah gitu. Tapi kita mulai dulu aja dari week 2-nya, di day 2-nya. Momen terbaik itu aku ada tiga momen terbaik ketika turnamen tersebut. Momen pertama tuh ada di Ukraine versus Rusia. Decknya adalah Discard Aggro versus Vyzoi gitu. Terus ada momen kedua ketika Belgium lawan Poland, itu game pertama kalau nggak salah. Terus ada momen ketiganya Belgium versus Poland lagi. Tapi yang ini game ketiganya gitu, dan itu semuanya seru-seru banget gitu. Oke, kita langsung aja ke video yang pertama adalah momen pertama Ukraine versus Rusia dengan deck yang tadi udah aku sebutkan, Discard Aggro dan Vyzoi gitu. Kenapa di sini aku bikin jadi momen terbaik pertama ya? Karena di sini yang menang itu adalah Discard Aggro, padahal lawannya adalah Vyzoi yang seharusnya Vyzoi ini bisa ngenahan banget Discard Aggro gitu. Nah, untungnya dari Ukraine ini dia punya augmented experimenter dua kali kalau nggak salah. Jadi dia bisa, kalau augmented experimenter kan dia kalau dia di summon di play dia bakal ngedamage 3 dan bakal ngediscard 3 kartu di tangan kita, dan dia bakal ngedraw 3 kartu lagi kan. Nah, si Ukraine ini kalau nggak salah dia dapat dua kali augmented experimenternya, jadi dia bisa nge-cycle terus dan nggak kehabisan kartu gitu kan. Biasanya discard aggro ataupun aggro lainnya tuh dia bakal kehabisan kartu kalau udah long term gitu kan mainnya, apalagi lawan Vyzoi yang bisa nge-stalling discard aggro lama banget. Nah, discard aggro ini yang dipakai Ukraine ini mungkin hoki dari draw-nya gitu kan, makanya bisa nahan juga dari Vyzoi-nya gitu, ngikutin long term-nya dari Vyzoi gitu. Terus dapat augmented experimenter lagi, terus yang keduanya diturunin lagi, dan pas akhir-akhir match-nya malah sampai bisa nge-level upin Jinx-nya, dan Jinx-nya sampai bisa ngeluarin roketnya tuh, gila nggak tuh. Padahal lawannya Vyzoi yang banyak heal, terus ada Celestial yang heal dan lain-lainnya gitu. Oke, kita langsung aja lihat videonya di momen pertama kali.
This is a bit awkward because if no matter what they play, unless it's a Sum Treasure or a Ballistic Bot, if they play Celestial, because if they play the Sum Treasure or the Ballistic Bot, they can actually PO cast into it. But they're not, dude, they're not afraid. They're like, they don't want them to develop. They really see. They have psychic powers here, man. They know they have an augmenter experimenter. They know.
Not just that, you know, if they develop now, of course, I think they have to with 8 mana, well, 11 mana to work with. But yeah, if they develop before the attack happens, experimenter comes down, deletes the units of the 2-for-1 kind of, and then the attack comes in and it's even, you know, it's even more damage. So there's really no point in doing that. Now we see it happen here.
Well, there's a pill cascade though. Like the pill cascade could allow them to preserve the unit.
And they're going
to
use
it now. So interesting to see, but they really did not want them to develop that that experimenter. As they draw more mushrooms. But there's a star shaping. That's what we're talking about, man. That health gain. Ooh, okay, that's a lot of tempo here. But again, they're already done with their attack. That star shaping is great for Russia. Fantastic, yeah. Russia.
This hand would be fantastic on the attack because it could be very explosive. But after the attack, and considering the stage we are in the game, it's very quick tempo, very, you know, impactful, but in a very small dose, and it won't really, I think, be the cards that they're going to change the game. It's not a Jinx being drawn. It's not a crowd favorite when you have a full board, for example. So, not really ideal. And this is the stage of the game where now you have star shaping at burst speed, obviously, so you can kind of commit that on the next attack token turn, even when Ukraine does attack again. And Russia, I think, going to take control of the game here. Has the ballistic bot to read an ignition next turn for some treasure to cycle and try and find more lifesteal or just more, you know, kind of game-ending win conditions, like Submersible, like maybe, just more star shaping, I think, is something you always want to see.
I think you preserve the thermogenic beam here. I think you hold on to that for Jinx, because Jinx is the only way Ukraine has a shot at winning, not only because of the extra card draw, but because of the super mega death rockets. So the good thing about star shaping is that because it is burst speed, they can play it whenever they actually truly need it. So they don't have to rush into it, and they can focus their mana this time around on developing their board. But I don't expect a Sump Dredger nor thermogenic beam here to go down for Russia. I think they will carry over the spell mana, as we are going to see a Get Excited onto the Ballistic Bot to deny that. So I think this is a good call by Ukraine. Their hope is to have a wide board and to be able to utilize this Flame Chompers to just get rid of the blocker and take the game with that vision. And, look! Ukraine's like, Yu-Gi-Oh!
Another way to refuel.
I hate what happens, man.
At this stage in the game, but you know, to counteract that, the Fangs was drawn for Team Russia, so a little bit more lifesteal and obviously some card advantage off of the Invoke as well. A Hush can maybe help against card favorite. We've seen one played and it got Equinoxed and one that has been discarded, so not too likely at this point in the game. And yeah, I think the Thermal Beam being saved probably for a Jinx just to have a clean answer for 4 mana.
I love how they prioritize this Percival over the Fangs in case an experimenter were to happen here. Yeah, this is huge. This is the best top deck they could. Oh my. And I think a thermogenic beam is happening this time around, which just opens up the board for the Zonite. Oh my God, dude. Ukraine has no pathetic cards in their deck, as they are just, man, sometimes when you're at that level, you draw what you need.
And we talked about, you know, them looking pretty deflated, but discard aggro is a kind of deck that sometimes you have a low percent chance, but if you get the two right top decks back to back with experimenters coming in, you have a chance to really just create, you know, kind of a staggered third or fourth attack very late into the game, even against matchups that have control and that have lifesteal. The Charger, Moonglow, and Crescent Strike coming in. Crescent Strike probably not the best, because an open attack will happen next turn. It's during the full board. There's no chance to develop for Team Ukraine, so it doesn't really make too much sense, I think. But the Charger, also not the greatest option with only one health and mostly trying to block in this matchup.
Yeah, you definitely gotta play the Fangs. You still have access to that Thermogenic Beam, which can remove one of the bodies, but I'm not sure if Russia, like if Ukraine doesn't do anything, I'm pretty sure that Thermogenic Beam will not be played, because you can assume that they have more units to fill up this board with, right? You're kind of like doing them a favor by going for this thermogenic beam. This is scary for all of a sudden, like they seem they were in absolute control and now they aren't, and they can't really afford to attack with the Fangs because of what we mentioned prior, because they have to assume that they have more units in hand. So if they trade the Fangs into something like the 2-1 jury rig, then they're just gonna, you know, play something else to take that spot, and all of a sudden they lost a blocker for the next open attack. So this is one of the key things here, is that they can use that Flame Chompers to drag that lifesteal unit all the way to the right to make it so that they threaten lethal before that Fangs manages to trade in with the lifesteal, which makes it so that I don't know if this star shaping is ultimately enough. This is a precarious position. I mean, they do have Hush that can take away a little bit of power from this, especially after that second vision is applied, but that's only looking at two power taken away from one unit. I don't know about you. I gotta stop being lazy. All right, let's actually do some maths here. Okay, so you can talk for a little bit, because I can have all
that. I'm gonna mention that, you know, obviously regardless of the attack coming in with 5 healing and possibly the Hush on Teemo, I think to stop the 2 attack obviously, and then just the you know, the mushrooms as well, and allowing the 5/5 to block maybe something bigger. You'll have a chance at obviously reducing a lot of the HP for Russia, but 2 Get Excited were played already, I believe, so the chance of burning them out at fast speed on the attack token turn.
This limits their plays. This limits their options. Now they have star shaping, but if they were to draw something like Get Excited, they cannot Get Excited and Hush on top of that. This is
the Jinx.
Oh,
this is the high roll deck for a reason. Discard aggro, if they find the right cards in the right order, they seem unstoppable. The amount of pure tempo they can create even late into the game is really uncomparable to any other aggro deck in the game.
Oh, and they have the Jinx into Rummage to level her up as well, in case that they somehow don't find lethal here. But we see they top deck a Fangs. It's over. Like they block into the 5-3, and then we're looking at 8, 11, 14. Yeah, one off lethal. It's over. They actually pulled. That's crazy. The augment, like, there is no topic in this game that is as impactful as augmented experimenter. It is the ultimate Exodia, man. It is crazy.
And it's the reason why discard aggro as an aggro deck has been one of the highest play rate decks and highest win rate decks that hasn't received any nerfs in the past, 6 months or so. It's maybe a bit hard to pilot at the beginning. You have to get, the intricate synergies between all the different cards, but it's really the only aggro deck that can, like we mentioned, deflate mid game and then still find a fuel with the experimenter. It's really the only tool in any aggro deck in the game that can come back into the game. We're on turn 10 against a deck that has a lot of control tools, a lot of lifesteal with the fangs and star shaping. And this is the only deck really discard aggro that if it hits the right cards at the right time in the late stages of the game can still come back in and create a third or fourth wave of attacks.
My God. Like this is, I think this is like the best aggro, like the best designed aggro deck in the game. Actually, wait.
The hustle takes away too.
So they'll
survive on 1 HP.
Oh, yeah.
There are still mushrooms in the deck. And of course, if Jinx.
And they level up Jinx. After they play the Hush, they play Jinx, they go for Rummage, they draw one card, which means they get the Rocket. So it's over. Like, Jinx, they draw so well. Let's not sugarcoat it. They are top deck gods, boy. They do deny. Yeah, that's a good targeting. The Teemo here is obviously the best because you deny the mushrooms. You survive a one. Oh, this Jinx and Tavros is gonna feel. I don't want to see Curse Keeper, nor Mr. Mighty Poro. I want to see the one Russian player that has a webcam.
The Fangs will lifesteal back up to 4 HP, but like we mentioned, the Rocket dealing 4 damage. Not, two mana now to work with for Rushers, so they're pretty much out of contention. Oh, they have to waste all of their mana on the fast speed response to the attack. Rummage comes in onto the House Fighter. There's Jinx level up occurs.
There's nothing they draw that they can't play here. There's absolutely nothing that they draw that they can't play here. Wow.
There's the Battlecaster coming down.
Wow, there it is. Just clean, perfect lethal. And Russia doesn't even want to see the rock. I mean, who can blame them? Oh my God, man. That was dirty.
Okay, gimana tadi? Momen pertama, menurut kalian, Ukraina versus Rusia dengan deck discard aggro lawan Faizoinya. Kalian bisa komen di bawah gitu. Okay, kita lanjut aja ke momen yang kedua adalah ketika Belgium melawan Poland gitu. Di sini Belgium gunain deck yang menarik banget ya adalah Nautilus Maokai, dan sedangkan Poland mencoba melawannya dengan Zoe Diana gitu. Ini pasti sangat seru banget karena Nautilus versus Zoe dan Diana gitu. Dan di sini dimenangkan oleh Poland ya game pertamanya dengan cara Atrocity. Atrocity ini, padahal dari Belgiumnya udah bisa sedikit lagi untuk menang di situ, dan udah juga dia gunain si monster yang bisa ngurangin powernya lawan gitu kan, dan seharusnya ketika dari deck Poland ini nggak punya salah satu kartu yang bisa nambah attack itu, seharusnya bisa menang Belgium gitu, tapi sayangnya Poland masih mempunyai jawaban atas efek dari si monster tersebut gitu yang bisa ngurangin min 3 gitu. Aku lupa namanya, nanti aku bakal coba taruh di samping gitu. Oke, kita langsung aja masuk ke momen keduanya. Selamat menonton.
Next turn with no Hush on Terror and a full swing.
Oh, wait. I forgot the about the Equinox. Oh, I forgot. Oh,
that's gonna be it.
Oh, that's it. I can't believe I forgot about that card. I was so focused on Hush.
Unless a Bone Skewer is drawn.
No, because they need. I mean, they need to. They have Spell Shield.
So yeah, you would need. Yeah, never mind. And they have to have already a target. And yeah, it's over. 100%.
Over. Oh wow! I can't. I was so focused on the Hush that I forgot about the Equinox they made earlier with the Fangs.
And that was the reason for it. They couldn't stop the Terror of the Tides on the attack token turn, but they knew that if they committed the Hush the last turn, they needed to have a way of silence and Abyssal Eye if it was played in response to Grief Beyond.
And like you said, they needed the ramp anyways. They needed to Hush the ramp regardless. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a wrap. Wow. Yeah, they're going to sneak in. This Atrocity just does it. There's nothing they can top that. And they top the most score. Oh, God. Not like this. Oh, my Lord. I mean, to be fair, no. They have Fail Casket, but it will not be enough. Oh, man. And
there's an attack debuff as well, but it's not enough to really matter for the Grey Beyond.
Shishu right there just like, you know, chilling. We got this.
They know in the deck, there's really no chance for anything to happen. You would need, I suppose, a double Bone Skewer, but yeah, you can lifesteal to seven.
Wait!
But the Pale Cascade in response will still seal it here.
God. I can't believe this. That was so tight. They still get exactly
what a back and forth over the last two turns. We got debated, I think, seven different times, Mogul.
Nah, kita sudah masuk ke momen yang terakhir, momen ketiga pilihanku adalah Belgium versus Poland lagi. Emang Belgium versus Poland ini menarik banget sih menurutku dari pemilihan decknya dan keseruannya gitu. Dan yang terakhir ini adalah paling seru banget, Nautilus Maokai versus Teemo Yzdrill. Jadi si Poland ini dia nggunain trik biar si Belgium ini segera segera deep gitu. Dia ngebuat deck Nautilus Maokai-nya biar cepet-cepetan berkurang kartunya, sehingga nantinya ketika decknya Belgium udah tinggal dikit dan ketika ngedraw, jamur yang udah ditanam oleh Poland itu bakal keluarnya lebih banyak dan lebih cepet gitu. Lebih cepet dan lebih banyak dapetnya, jamurnya lebih gede gitu. Jadi makanya di sini si Poland itu nggak ngehancurin si scarab-nya, dia ngebiarin si scarab-nya hidup punyanya Belgium, sehingga nantinya kalau ada unit yang mati, si Belgium bakal ngetos terus-menerus gitu. Itu triknya Poland ketika ngelawan Nautilus Maokai. Jadi menurutku ini kalau kalian pengen lihat seru banget, kalian harus lihat full videonya sih pas ketika Nautilus Maokai versus Teemo Yzdrill ini di bagian match Belgium versus Poland. Kalau nggak salah ini game ketiga, game terakhir yang bakal dimenangin oleh Poland gitu dengan skor nantinya 1-2 gitu. Oke, kita langsung aja lihat cuplikannya gitu dari momen ketiga kali ini.
I'm like, Shucky's out of here. Doesn't want to see this.
Nautilus has to come down just to repopulate the deck. Yeah.
Yeah.
Try and make the odds
a bit more. They're waiting
more in
for
favor
that.
Of Team Belgium. That means they have zero mana now, so nothing else. That Poland now has the ability to really decide what is the most effective way to add more mushrooms into the deck before the four draws happen next turn with three foundries on the board.
Yeah, just go for this, and then you just go for like a flash freeze or whatever. Four cards left. Oh, come on. I wanted to see how many mushrooms they threw.
Nah, sampai di sini momen bareng Simpanse Gaming di Master Europe kali ini di week 2 day 2-nya. Kemungkinan nanti bakal week 3 day 1 dan day 2 bakal aku coba cari momen yang terbaik untuk aku share gitu ke kalian semua, yang kalian yang belum sempat nonton ataupun yang udah nonton ataupun kalian yang punya opini lain sendiri tentang momen terbaik di Master Europe nantinya ataupun di week 2 day 2 ini, kalian bisa tulis di kolom komentar di bawah gitu. Terima kasih sampai di sini, sampai jumpa di video selanjutnya. Bye bye.